Hello guys, so this time I'm going to tell you, it's a bit more of a story time again. I'm going to tell you a story. Not something that I'm particularly good at, storytelling, but I'm going to give it a darn good try. So if you're wondering where I am at the moment, I'm in Forverton, which is just outside Exeter. Just been down to see a job down here. Going to make my way back now. Lovely little place though, really, really nice. Got a nice little corner shop over there as well, where they sell pies. A village square, a ford, normally that pub is quite a decent place, Thorferton Arms. Yeah, one of those nice places, War Memorial, get your words out, down there. It's where I filmed the CBR 500 video many years ago now, 3 or 4 years ago. So today this is a story about my 21st birthday. Actually, let's check I'm still recording. I've already done this video and then it bummed out on me, the camera. Oops, wrong gear. So yeah, my 21st birthday. So I wanted to, this was back in 1998. The world was very, very different then, wasn't it? That's for sure. Yeah, so 1998, my 21st birthday, I wanted something which I could really remember it by and have a good memory. Now, before we go too far, I need to state actually that this is a very blue story here. It's quite rude and it's got lots of sexy time stuff in it. So if you're around kids or, you know, don't like a bit of cringe against, you know, naughtiness and strippers and the things that can happen with strippers, then you need to turn off now. You've been warned. There you go. Right, for all the other normal people, we'll carry on. So 21st birthday, and just ironically on my birthday, it just so happened, which was very rare back then, that there was a stripper night at the local nightclub. We had about four in Exeter at the time, back in the day, in 1998, and this was at the Hot House. So I thought, well, that'd be a good idea, let's go down there. So I got me mates together and we decided to trot on down there after a couple of beers before. Now I'm not particularly, how do I describe myself? I'm one of those people that if you said, right, let's go out tonight, you know, and get rat ass and blah, 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 I'm normally the one that will say, well, okay, but I might go home a bit early, you know, it's not really my bag that. Let's have a look at this actually, it's nice here. Because it's, you know, I don't want to, you know, be out too long or whatever. Kind of on the wrong side here really, aren't I? So anyway, yeah, went out to the pub, had a few beers, yeah, had a nice time. So we thought, right, okay, let's get down to the nightclub then, go and see these strippers and what it's all about. So off we went, got down there, had a few drinks, show started. I had a comedian first, show started. Two really pretty ladies come out. There was a brunette and a blonde one was from Wales. Real Welsh beauty she was, nice and proportioned in every way, and yeah, and they come out and you know, everyone's like, you know, rowdy bunch of monkeys in there, you know, hooray, you know, bunch of 20-year-olds at the time, you know, 20-30-year-olds, and yeah, next minute they started kissing, blah blah blah. That was when the room went silent. That was quite something actually. So yeah, the room went silent when that was going on. And just gonna turn my ignition off a minute. So yeah, room went silent then. Next minute, now remember that I'm dressed up in birthday gear. As in, you know, I got badges saying, oh, 21, you know, 21 years old today. You know, and all the jokey badges that you can get with these things. And yeah, so, oh, that's pretty as well, isn't it? So next minute, the girls, you know, after they stop kissing each other and doing other things to each other, they come over to us. You know, my mate next to me, Jimma, was there, and she said, oh, take off my bra. And he was like, oh, okay, yeah, right then. Anyway, 2 minutes later, he still couldn't do it. So he was struggling like hell to get her bra off. Anyway, she gave up in the end, and I can't remember if he got it done in the end or whether she just done it herself. Either way, they didn't hang around any longer. That was the end of that. Took her bra off. Next minute, I'm being pulled up on stage, and this is where I start to think, nothing bad can happen here, it should be fine, I thought. Then she's taken my shirt, I had a shirt at the time, she's taken my shirt off and unbuttoning my shirt and taking it off, and I was like, oh, I'm not too sure about this. She's like, no, no, it's okay, it'll be okay, and I thought, bloody hell. And she was, you know, really good looking as well, you know, so bear that in mind. And, yeah, unbuttoning my shirt, this is the blonde one, and, next minute, she's unbuttoning my trousers, and I'm thinking, okay, that's where the line is there, and, I don't, you know, don't want to do any more than that. She's, no, no, it's okay, don't worry, nothing to worry about. Oh, okay, easy for you to say. Yeah, took me trousers, down, so I'm stood there in my pants now. Next minute, my, she's down to me pants, I thought, she ain't going there, no chance. Like we would all think, wouldn't we? You do not want to take your pants off when you're in a nightclub and there's, you know, 100 other people there. Next minute, she's pulled out a dildo, bearing in mind I'm in my pants, and she's stuck it in her mouth. Or stuck it in my mouth, sorry. So I'm sat there, laid there, back, with a dildo in my mouth. I told you it was blue, it gets worse. With a dildo in my mouth, and then she sits on top of it, and then she's going up and down, and all I remember was thinking, I hope I don't crack a bloody tuff here. So she's going up and down on this bloody dildo. Obviously my view was very limited, everyone in the crowd is going wild, and then I thought, hang on a minute, what's going on here? And she's starting to take off me bloody pants, me boxers. So me boxers are down now, I'm absolutely like, the ground could have swallowed me up. That's not my bag at all. That's like my worst nightmare. But when you're there and the crowd are going wild and, you know, you're in that moment, everything just seemed the right thing to do, didn't it? You know, to do. So, you know, by then I thought, oh, you know, there's nothing I can do now. It's done. Oh, rough row end's closed. Looks a bit rough. So next, she's got a candle, and I thought, oh, what's going on here? And I thought, that's definitely not going anywhere on me, I can assure you of that. She'd already overstepped the line, and I'm not doing any more than, you know, this is like, you know, believe me, I was so, you know, I was so embarrassed. But anyway, she lit the candle, of course I'm laid there with everyone, you know, just deadly still. I didn't know what was happening. She's lit the candle, and then she started melting the wax on my chest, which bloody hurts, doesn't it? Nothing sexy about that, it bloody hurts. And then she puts the dildo back in your mouth again, and then, you know, sits on it again, on the dildo, and, well, obviously, the only thing I can see is her ass, right? Which is actually quite nice. It was all very, you know, very, very pleasant. It couldn't have happened to, you know, she's a very, very pretty lady indeed, say the least. But not when you was in that position where I was. So that happened, yeah. So she's now stuck a dildo back in my mouth. She sat on it with me there, laid out on the floor. I got wax stuck to my bloody chest and my belly, and I thought, oh no, I know what's going to happen now. She's going to basically, I'm basically going to get very, very lucky now indeed. And I thought I thought it's going to be a 69er job basically. Sorry it's so crude, I did warn you. So yeah, so I thought, oh here we go, this is where it's going to get really quite nice now. So I'm in the mode now where I'm thinking, you know, something's going to happen here. And then I felt it get warm around my middle area, and I thought, this is a bit where she's going to return the favour of the 69, shall we say. And I could feel her hands there. You know, it's quite nice. And I was just, like I say, I was getting in the zone now. I thought, you know what? I don't give a monkey's that about 100 people are looking at me here. It got nice and warm. Felt her hands down there, quite close. Bearing in mind, you know, I'm not excited in any way, okay? So, I'm not excited in any way because I'm just embarrassed more than anything else. So it gets really warm, and I know that this is going to happen now. Yeah, this is definitely going to happen. And I saw her head go down towards my middle bits. And then all of a sudden, everybody started laughing. I thought, what the hell's going on? Bearing in mind that it's feeling quite warm down there, I knew what was going to happen. And what she had done was got the candle and set a light to my pubes. So I was basically on fire for a moment. So that was it then. I thought, well, okay, you know, it was funny. It was funny, and I laughed about it. I'd never ever do it again. It's different when you're married and all the other things that, you know, when you're older, isn't it? But it was different back then. So yeah, that's what happened there. That was my 21st birthday. But I guess the point and the conclusion of this is that, for like anything in life, sometimes you have to go through that sort of thing to feel like you're alive and living. You need to feel that grit, don't you? And with all the wokies around these days, obviously that probably wouldn't happen these days. But it's right in what people used to say, was that it is character building, isn't it? It would never ever happen again now. No way. If they said go up on stage, I say no, definitely not. Isn't happening. I'm going somewhere else. But it's good to have memories like that. It's good to have. I wanted something that would burn in my brain. I didn't want that, but I wanted something which would really burn in my brain that I could remember. And I definitely got that night. And it is a fond memory now. You know, I could look at it as though, oh, they were awful to me, and, you know, they did this to me and that to me. But no, you got to be, like anything in life, you've got to be, look at things glass half full, haven't you? Or else you're kind of missing the whole point. You're missing the ride, really. You know, and recently I've been out with Nick as well. He fell off in the, famously, Nick's Ford, come off in the water there. Same thing again. It was unfortunate for him, but he was a really good sport about it. He laughed about it in the end, and he let me put it on as well, which I really appreciate, of course. And it's given everybody, all, you know, us lot, he was there on the day, giving us that memory, but also you guys as well, who watched it, will always remember that moment. And moments like that is really what it's all about, I think. You know, it's like these days with comedy, the way it is, you know, it's everybody getting cancelled. It's such a load of shite, because that's what gets you through hard times, is the coarse grit of comedy. But I wanted to share that with you, that little story time. I'm not sure when I'll put it out. I might even put this out in the winter time, maybe. But I thought that would give you a laugh anyway. But yeah, make memories, isn't it? That is honestly what it's all about. Even when you don't feel like going out, go out and see who you're going to meet, or what experiences you're going to get. Can't go wrong. I want to thank you very much for listening to that. As I say, I'm not the best storyteller in the world, but you don't become the best by not doing it, do you? You become the best by doing it. So that's what I'm doing, and you're my guinea pigs. So thanks very much for listening to that, guys. Hope you're well. Have a good week, whatever you're doing. And from me and the Royal Enfield Meteor, we'll see you next week. Thanks for watching.